Valley averaging 67 points a game, Plymouth averaging about 58. As we're getting ready for the tip-off here. And Valley will start the ball. Sechrist inside. No good. Three-point attempt is up, and that one is good. Haley Reichard. Addie Miller going to attempt a three of her own. No good off the back. Sechrist with the rebound. She lost it. That's going to be a kickball violation, and it will go to the Vikings. Hannah Dunn inside, no good. Broyette with the rebound. Sechrist will go inside, can't get it. She'll go to the line for two. And the first one's good from Sechrist. And she'll go 2-2 from the line. Loses the ball. It's going to go to Valley. Miller thought about it, didn't go to. Ah, oh, she gave it to the wrong team. Bad pass there by Miller. But she's going to take it back, and Sophie Buzzard will pick it up. Sechrist inside. It's not going to count. Boriette will be set to inbound. Hannah Dunn inside, couldn't get it, gets her own rebound. Couldn't get it that time. Buzzard's gonna come up with it. Miller for three, no good. Valley hasn't been making the shots that they need to. Three-point attempt. That one is good. Allie Andrews. Broyette's going to try her own three, and she got it. That one broken up there. Valley's going to come up with the ball. Seacrest slings it out to Broyette. And Seacrest going to get a hold of the ball. Pilgrim ball here. Little discussion between the officials. Long three-point attempt, no good. Miller with the rebound. That'll be a foul call. Allie Andrews calling for the foul. Emily Peterson coming in for Valley. Boyette almost lost it there. Dunn inside, and she got it. And that one's going to sail out of bounds. Valley with a one-point lead here. Seacrest inside and banks it in. I'll give Seacrest 4 points. She averages about 14 a game. She had 13 in that loss to Appleton North. That shot no good. And Seacrest is going to be called for the foul. That'll be her first of the night. And blocked the shot there, and it went out of bounds, and it's going to go to Valley. Dunn almost lost it, able to get it to Broyette. Buzzard for two, and she'll get it. That one tips, Seacrest got it. Inside, didn't go in, but she'll head to the line. And we'll have a timeout. As I said before, Ann Seacrest averages about 14 points a game. Allie Andrews for Plymouth averaging about 15 a game, so good matchup there. And And Seacrest is leading Valley with 4 points right now. Meredith Broyette with three, followed by Sophie Buzzard and Hannah Dunn with two apiece. As Valley has a 5-point lead here. Seacrest heading to the line already, 2 for 2. And she'll get the first. And she'll get the second. So Ann's 4-4 on the night at the line. Andrews almost lost it there, able to pick it up. Fight for the ball. And it'll stay with the Pilgrims. And that one will go to bounds. Possession will go to the Vikings. Peterson for three, couldn't get it off the back. Rebounded by Buzzard. And Buzzard will head to the line. And Buzzard will make the first one. And the second. She'll go 2-2 at the line. And that'll be a foul on O'Connor. Almost lost the ball there. Pilgrim's able to retain. Buzzard almost came up with it. That one off the front. And that ball is going to go to the Vikings. Casey Peters calling for the foul on Plymouth. Under 20 to go here in the first. Valley just needs to hold on to it here. Broyette gonna shoot a three, and she got that one. And that's the end of the first. Tippecanoe Valley leading here 18-6. Both Broyette and Sechrist have 6 points apiece. Buzzard has four. And a good first quarter for the Vikings. Getting ready here to start the second quarter. Valley leading by 12 points here. Peterson sets to inbound, gives it to Tripedi. Tripedi now in for Valley. Kylie Sloan will not be competing in this game due to a foot injury, as that one goes out of bounds. Three-point attempt, no good from Andrews. Now it's going to be a jump ball. And it'll go to the Pilgrims. Andrews up, no good. Miller loses it. Oh, she's going to be called a travel there. O'Connor gonna come up with a rebound. Sechrist inside, could not get it. But she'll head to the line again. She's already 4 for 4. So will she, if she can improve that? And she'll stay 100%. 5 for 5, and she'll try to go for 6 here. 6 for 6. And that'll give Ann 8 points on the night. And extends Valley's lead to 14. That'll be a foul on Miller. That'll be her first. Jump ball is going to go to the Vikings. Peterson will be set to inbound. Hey. Seacrest couldn't get a hold on it, but Miller comes up with the save there. Now it'll go out of bounds, and it'll go to the Pilgrims. And Dunn comes back in for Valley. Three-point attempt, no good off the back. Miller comes up with it. She's gonna try a three, and she'll get that. First point of the night for Miller as we have a timeout on the court. Valley leading here 23-6, 5:22 to go here in the first half. Seacrest leads Valley with 8 points. Boyette and Buzzard both have 6. Buzzard has 4, Boyette has 6. And Seacrest is 100% from the line, shooting 6 for 6 so far in this contest. Getting ready here to restart. Pilgrims will have the ball. Loses the ball. Hannah Dunn will go to the line. Dunn makes the first one. Hannah Dunn signed on with Anderson University to continue her athletic career. And she'll go 2 of 2. Seacrest couldn't get a hold of it. Buzzard's gonna get a hold of it. Buzzard will take it herself. Couldn't get the shot, but she did get the foul, and she'll head the line for 2. Buzzard already 2 of 2 at the line. She makes the first one. Right now, Valley is 100% on free throws in this game. That's a good stat to have. Two of two at the line that time. 4 of 4 overall. For Buzzard. Loses the ball, Seacrest will come up with it. Buzzard couldn't get a handle on it. And the Pilgrims will pick it back up. And it'll stay with the Pilgrims. Yeah. Shot no good. Rebounded. Still no good. Sechrist had it but lost it. And it's going to stay with the Pilgrims. Sophie Buzzard call for the foul, her first. 3-point attempt is up, no good. Sechrist with the rebound. Peterson for three, no good. Buzzard takes it up, still no good, gets her own rebound. And she'll go to the line. Buzzard already 4 for 4. And she'll stay 100%. And she'll go 6 of 6 overall. Valley still 100% from the free throw line. And that one will stay with the Pilgrims. O'Connor will come back in for Valley. Sechrist going to take a break. That shot no good. Age O'Connor gonna be called for the foul. That's her second of the night. Hallie Reichert at the line makes the first one. Meredith Bourriette will come back in for Valley. She makes the second one. Three to go here in the first half. Valley with a comfortable lead. Miller for three, she got it. That'll give Miller 6 points on the night, all from perimeter. And that one's gonna sail out of bounds and go to Valley. Miller will inbound to Buzzard. Buzzard inside, and she'll get that. That'll give Buzzard 10 points on the night. Peterson couldn't get a hold of it. Hannah Dunn going to be called for the foul. Number 10, Claire Tanner, was the one who made the basket and the free throw. travel call there on Peterson. Seacrest will come back in. Turnover again. Buzzard will come up with it. Seacrest will go to the line to shoot two. She's already 6 for 6, 100%. We'll see if she can continue that streak here. And she does. One more shot for Ann. And Ann is now 8 for 8 at the line. That gives Ann 10 points on the night. 3-point attempt, and that one is good. Number 22, Jenna Nifong. The Valley still the comfortable lead here. Just over a minute in the first half as Dunn will be called for the travel. That shot, no good. Rebounded by Buzzard. Broyette's open in the lane, and she'll get two. That'll give Broyette 8 points on the night. That shot, good there. Cassidy Holiday for the Pilgrims. Valley will try to hold on to the ball here. Done. Oh, she couldn't get it. Under 10 here. That's going to be a travel call. Valley will have the ball here with barely over 6 seconds to go in the half. And they'll probably just loft one up. And that's no good. And your score at halftime, Tippecanoe Valley 38, Plymouth 16. And we'll be right back after halftime. And welcome back here. We're getting ready to start the second half of play. Tippecanoe Valley leading here 38-16. And Seacrest and Sophie Buzzard lead Valley with 10 points apiece, followed by Meredith Broyette with 8. Valley will start off with the ball here to start the third quarter. And that'll go out of bounds on Plymouth. Boriette will inbound. Hannah Dunn for two. That'll give Dunn 6 points on the night. Sechrist comes up with the ball. Boyette inside. That'll stay with Valley. Buzzard inside. She got it. That'll give Buzzard 12 points on the night. She leads Valley in scoring here for this game so far. Still plenty of ball left. Three-point attempt. No good. Sechrist comes up with it. That's going to be a travel call there on Dunn. That one no good. Sechrist with the rebound. But the ball will change possession. Addie Miller called for her second foul. That shot no good there from Andrews. That'll be an over and back. That one no good. I believe Sechrist had a hand on that one. Dunn couldn't keep a hold of it. And it'll roll into the hands of the Pilgrims. Royette call for her first foul. Loses the ball. And it'll go to Valley. Ball out of a timeout. So Valley leading here 42-16. Both of these teams beat Logansport. Valley beating them 94-24, almost a 100-point game for Valley. Plymouth beat Logansport 75-30. Yeah. Broyette for three, and she'll get it. That'll give Broyette 11 points on the night. Valley now with three players in double digits and scoring. That shot off the front iron. Sechrist inside, she got it. And she'll head to the line, try to make a three-point play here. Sechrist already 8 for 8 at the line for Valley. She'll try to go 9 of 9 to keep Valley at 100%, and she does. So Valley is still 100% on the free throw shooting, as they have a comfortable lead here, 48-16. Three-point attempt, no good. That three-point attempt, no good. That one will go out of bounds. And the Pilgrims will take a timeout here. And Sechrist is leading Valley here with 13 points, followed closely by Buzzard with 12, who's followed closely by Broyette with 11. So again, three players on the Valley squad in double digits as far as scoring goes. And again, Valley is 100% from the free throw line. Reichert scores there for Plymouth. Sechrist inside. Easy points there for her. That'll give Sechrist 15. Sechrist got a hand on it. Broyette came up with it. She still got it. Buzzard inside. That'll give Buzzard 14. Three-point attempt. No good. Broyette for three. She hesitated a little bit. I think if she would have shot it on that first chance, I think she would have got it. Three-point attempt. That one is good. Number 22, Jenna Nifong for the Pilgrims. Sechrist shuffle passes it inside to Dunn. Somebody. Buzzard will take it away there. Seacrest goes up. Oh, she couldn't get it. Jump ball. Emily Peterson and Olivia Trapiti coming back in for Valley. Still yet to see the court are Tanisha Brown and Mackenzie Woodcox. But I have a feeling we might see them here in the fourth quarter. Broyette for three. She got it. Broyette now has 12 points from beyond the arc. 14 in total. Another three-point attempt. That one way off the mark. Peterson coming up with it. And one last shot. Oh, almost had it. And at the end of three, Tippecanoe Valley leading here 57-21. Right now, Valley is 17 of 17 from the line. Pretty good stat right there. You don't see that many nights. And Seacrest has 15 points for Valley. Broyette with 14. I believe Buzzard has 14 as well. That she does. Looks like Asia O'Connor will be in now for Valley. That shot good there. Courtney Cook for the Pilgrims. That one taken away, and Cook is open there. Oh, she missed the layup. Gotta make those shots. And that one will go out of bounds. That one will not count. And Seacrest call for the foul. That's her second foul. Andrews for two. Oh, that one taken there. Andrews gets another two. Coach Kenda calls a timeout. And Coach Kenda is not happy right now. Tippecanoe Valley is 1-0 in the TRC. And on December 17th, we're going to have a big matchup in South Whitley as Tippecanoe Valley will take on the undefeated Whitco Wildcats. That is a conference matchup. And I have a good gut feeling that one of those two teams will be the TRC champions this year, as Wico is very competitive this year. So good matchup there on the 17th of December. Tripedi is in for Valley, almost lost the ball. Seacrest couldn't get a hold of that one. I think it was a bad pass though by Broyette. Two shot attempt is good. That one by Jenna Nafong. And Seacrest, bad pass there. Coach Kendick calling another timeout, and he is not very happy right now. Valley with a 27-point lead here in the fourth quarter. Seacrest still leading Valley with 15 points, followed by Broyette and Buzzard with 14. Seacrest takes it. O'Connor inside, couldn't hold on to it. She'll head to the line. Valley is 17 of 17 at the line. O'Connor will be looking to improve it, and she does. So Valley still perfect from the stripe as she makes the second one. Well, that'll put Valley 19 of 19 from the line. So good night for Valley as a three-point attempt. No good off the back. Emily Peterson called for her first foul. Three-point attempt by Andrews. No good, stays in bounds, but it'll go to Valley. O'Connor inside, and she'll get it. Valley now here with a 31-point lead as that one goes out of bounds. Addie Miller will check in for Valley. Yet going to take a breather. That one is going to go out of bounds. Valley will keep the ball. Seacrest, that'll bounce in for her. That'll give Seacrest 17 points on the night. Nine of those points are from the line. That attempt no good. Miller for three. Oh, in and out. Rebounded by Tripedi. She couldn't get in. And it'll stay with Valley. Peterson inbounds to Sechrist, who gives it to Miller. That was a two attempt. Stays inbounds. Another three-point attempt. That one no good. Peterson call for second foul. That shot no good, but there will be a foul on the play. O'Connor call for her third foul. And that one will go in. Cassidy Holiday for the Pilgrims. CeCe Robinson. Got my numbers mixed up there. Miller will be called for the travel. O'Connor gonna be called for her fourth foul. She'll have to be careful as to not get fouled out. CeCe Robinson at the line again for the Pilgrims. She misses the first one. She'll make the second. As Valley still leading here by 30. Pilgrims are all over Tripedi. Coach Kenda calls a timeout. Hannah Dunn will now be coming in for Valley. We still have yet to see Tanisha Brown or Mackenzie Woodcox, as they're the final two players on the bench for Valley. And Sechrist is leading Valley with 17 points, followed by Buzzard and Broyette with 14 apiece. Peterson set to inbound. That one stays inbounds. Hey. Valley still with the ball here. Allie Andrews called for the foul. Her fourth. She'll have to be careful for the Pilgrims. Of course, Valley done a good job this game in suppressing Andrews, as Seacrest will get two there. And that'll give Seacrest 19. And season high for a game is 20. So she might be looking to break her personal record there this season. As that one will go out of bounds. And Tanisha Brown will now come in for Valley. First time Brown seeing the court for tonight. O'Connor will come back in. Dunn loses the ball. Asia O'Connor called for her fifth foul, and she'll be fouled out of the game. Boyette comes in for O'Connor. That shot no good. And I think it's safe to say that Valley's gonna walk away with the win here. Pilgrims tried to sail in here and claim this land for themselves as Brown, oh, couldn't get it. As I was saying, the Pilgrims tried to sail in here and claim Viking territory, but the Vikings hold their ground. And they will come out of here with a dominating win. Peterson with the ball, and she will go for two. That's Peterson's first points of the night. 3-point attempt, no good off the front bar. Dunn, I believe, calling for the foul. That's her second. First one no good there. Olivia Tripedi will come in for Valley. Second one no good. Rebounded by the Pilgrims. That'll be a kick ball. So Valley gonna walk away with the win here, and they'll move to 6-2, as the Pilgrims will move to 6-2 as well. That shot no good, rebound no good. Hannah Dunn will pick up her third foul. Valley's next game will be on December 7th against Triton here at home. Yeah. Ball up in the air. Little tussle for it. It'll go to the Valley. And Valley will just let the clock run here. So Valley gonna walk away with the win here as they win 67-34. And well, that's the bottom line because the scoreboard says so. I'm Chris Sechrist, and you've been listening to an RTC Channel 4 presentation of Indiana High School basketball. Good night, folks.